Back at the compound. Where else, right? Well, got rid of a lot of the pallets. Just got some odd ones left, so those will stay there, at least for now. Working on this pile of scrap aluminum. And as you can see, this is really being cleaned up. Only a little bit of stuff. And I'm not sure what I'm going to work on today. Should it be wire? I don't know. Should it be the truck? Boundless pile of aluminum? I don't know. Getting the white pickup going. Maybe raking the dirt and the rocks of all that broken material. Always a stubborn puddle of water left, because the water table, you just dig like maybe a couple inches down in the dirt and you hit the water table, because that river, and it's still at flood stage. So over here, the ground kind of starts sloping down. See how it's wet over there? This is a couple feet lower than over there. So the water just comes right out of the ground. There ain't nothing you can do about it. This is the lowest spot on the property. If you go over there, that's probably a good 15 or 20 feet higher all the way down there, the elevation. So, yep, this is the lowest spot on the entire property where I'm at. Now that other Craftsman that needs, I don't know if it needs a battery. That's a good bag, I think. You know, I was thinking, there's so much of this right here, it's probably almost sellable. Like at a flea market or something. Or it could just be scrap. That's quite a bit. I'm amazed that somebody actually threw it away. Either way, it's worth something. It's really hard to get the wire out of these, though. I don't know. For whatever reason, it's hard to get the wire out of there. So I consider that kind of stuff slow scrap. It's tempting, because the copper inside has some value. Now this machine right here, I'm not sure if it runs or not. I don't know, I forgot what kind of wheel this is right here. Looks like a GM wheel, but I don't think it is. Looks more like a Jeep. Well, this is a... that's a 225 R15, and 15s are getting kind of hard to find. This is something like this is definitely, I'm not gonna trash this out. This is keep life, or actually use life. A new term coined, right? Something that I could definitely use. Same thing with these tires. I was going to cut the tire, but I realized, well, these old crappy trailers, they don't use those type of rims right there. Now I got some other kind of funky rim. They're so dang old. And this gooseneck area, this is really short, actually, compared to that boat trailer. I wonder why it has like a crank, like a cranking cable thing on there. What the heck could that be for? This one's got a wheel lift right there. This one doesn't. So if you loaded this thing without it being attached to another vehicle, it would probably be a bitch to lift up. You'd have to use like a jack or something like that. But I think me and my kid, we need to convert one of these things ASAP. Because they could be dedicated dreamers. That's my claim. I forgot I had this on here. This did work. Probably doesn't work anymore. So, while I'm making this flick for you guys to look at and be mildly amused, trying to figure out what the next move is, because I like just dealing with like scrap steel. It's so mindless. The other stuff you really have to sort out. There's like batteries, and you have to construct the load. This battery might be good. I don't know. I do know that I need a battery charger. Hiccup. I need a battery charger. Yep, junkyard mentality. I got that thing. I have an engine stand. I have the piece, so that's a complete thing right there. Got my snow thrower, got that John Deere, that's gonna just sit there for the eons, I suppose. Oh, there's another battery. That piece of junk actually runs. I couldn't believe it. There we go. We got too many people crying on my channel. Please don't scrap the Harbor Freight. Alright, well, we didn't. Comes complete with all the brushes and stuff, too. Maybe I could sell it. And then there's one of them tool stands. I've never used one of those in my life. They're just... something about them, they're just so wiggle wobbly, and I'm clumsy, and I'd be running into it all the time. I'm a fan of leaving my tools everywhere. And where's my wrench? Where's my drill? Like here. I left this thing outside. Again. Got rained on. Again. Mm-hmm. Me personally, I've never had a place of my own long enough where I could call it home and be set up and know and be insecure in my mind that I'm not going to have to move and be upheavaled. So it's like living out of a bucket, which sucks, because you spend half your time looking for your stuff. Is there a fix? No, there's not a fix. The only reason why there's not really a fix for that problem is because I've never had a place of my own where I could be left alone, and I know I was going to stay there for years. Like a house or even rented property. I mean, I don't know how much longer I'm going to... I don't know how much longer I'm going to be here. There's no way to know, really. When the old guy dies, they might sell all the property. So, I'll be back to living out of the back of my pickup truck. That should be really exciting. Oh, look at the ground is dry, kinda. Hear the exasperation of my voice? Oh, you get like me, and you don't know which way to go. Should I get that running? Should I move all this shit out of the way? Should I? Welcome to my madness. Where you don't know what the next move should be. Like, how do you focus? Like, I could totally focus on getting that truck going, but I know in the back of my head, even if I give my best effort to get that thing going today, I know I'm not going to, because I've got other things to do. Like, I have to get my kid from school, and once I leave here and I drive all the way, and the gas is like $3.50 a gallon right now, do I really want to spend the gas money to drive all the way back here to do what? Because by that time, if I go load up that truck, I'm not going to be able to go out and find anything later on, because the scrap yards will be closed, and blah, 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 blah. So I get in one of those head funks where you can't hardly think. You don't know, like, what the heck am I going to do next? And then, you know, I start getting myself on a roll, and then I have to take my kid out to the city so he can be with his friends and go to the bar and be a 26-year-old. And after all, this is nobody else's problem but mine. This is my own creation. I'm a master of my own disaster. But all this is built around the fact that I have this massive mortgage that I've never been able to get my arms around and pay the darn thing off. If I had that thing paid off, I would not have this. I would not have any of this. I'd have a couple of pickup trucks, a minivan, and maybe a box truck. That's it. That'd be the extent of my operation. And I would not be working full throttle at all. I'd be like maybe working when I feel like, when I want to, every once in a while, or maybe, I don't know, whatever. Stress, not as stressed out. Because it wouldn't be a massive bill to pay. You know what else? Well, the natural gas has been cut to the house, so I'm going to have to switch over to propane. Like, maybe get a propane, you know, have a propane service, drop off a tank. And, yeah, because that reduces the value of the house. You know, a potential buyer will be like, what? You can't heat the house. And if you convert it over to all electricity, like an all electric stove and all electric heat, the value of the house will go, it'll go way down because electricity is super expensive. It's not a cheap way to heat a home. Very inefficient. So, after you guys watch this boring video, I know everybody sees, I see nothing but money. Yeah, I know there's nothing but money, but there's like, I know what's in here. There's a lot of work. Okay. Especially for one man. And there's a whole bunch of different, like, weird shit in here. Whatever. See you in the next video.